Hello learners, I welcome you to AgriWatch. Today 27th March, let us discuss today's news highlights. New program to help small tea growers. A program to help and support the tea smallholders in collaboration with companies will be launched on 4th April 2019 in Kolkata. The program named Trinity has been developed mutually by the Netherlands-based sustainability organization Solidaridad, with presence of 52 nations and the India Tea Association in Kolkata. And the next news, UGC prohibits distance learning degree program in agriculture. The University Grant Commission has banned teaching distance degree program in agriculture. The Higher Education Regulator took the decision at its recent meeting for the reason that a degree program in agriculture is technical, because it requires practical or laboratory courses. The Union Agriculture Ministry had referred the issue to the Commission, urging to its consider banning universities from offering open and distance learning degree program in agriculture. According to UGC Open and Distance Learning Regulations 2017, professional programs like medicine, architecture, pharmacy, engineering, nursing, dental and physiotherapy are not allowed to be offered in distance mode. Let us see about UGC at a glance. UGC, the University Grant Commission, is a statutory body established by the Union Government, India, in accordance to the University Grants Commission Act 1956 under Human Resource Development Ministry. It coordinates and maintains standards of higher education in the country. Its headquarters is at New Delhi and the present chairperson is D.P. Singh. And the next highlight is center might pay up to rupees 19,000 crore to farmers. The government might pay up to rupees 19,000 crore to farmers through their flagship PM Kisan, that is Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi. It's a central security scheme with 100% funding from Government of India. It was announced during the Union Budget in February, and 1.5 crore small and marginal farmer households were to receive rupees 6,000 a month, which is to be paid in 3 installments of rupees 2,000 each. That is rupees 6,000 a year, rupees 2,000 each installment. It has become operational from 1st December 2018. Next news is Indian basmati rice industry to clock its higher export ever. The Indian basmati rice industry is on the verge of clocking its highest ever export of around rupees 30,000 crore in the financial year 2019. Previous highest record is rupees 29,300 crore in the financial year 2014. According to a report of ICRA release, the ICRA means Indian Independent and Professional Investment Information and Credit Rating Agency. Let us see a glance about basmati. Basmati is long grain aromatic rice grown for many centuries in the specific geographical area at the Himalayan foothills of Indian subcontinent. The major basmati varieties are Basmati 386, Pusa Basmati 1. Friends, please note the varieties of Basmati. Basmati 386, Pusa Basmati 1, Basmati 217, Pusa Basmati 1121, Ranbir Basmati, Punjab Basmati 1, Karnal Local or Tarori Basmati, Haryana Basmati 1, Basmati 370, Kasturi, and Type 3 or Dehraduni Basmati. And there are some more basmatis are there. So far, 29 varieties of basmati rice have been notified under the Seed Act 1966. I have discussed a few. And the regions in India which are major producers of basmati rice is Jammu and Kashmir, Delhi, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Punjab, western parts of Uttar Pradesh, Haryana and Rajasthan. And the next highlight is Walmart Foundation supports IDEI irrigation project in Andhra Pradesh. More than 62% of the population of Andhra Pradesh are dependent on agriculture and lack access to irrigation system or other technologies to help them improve their productivity and income. 10,000 smallholder farmers in Andhra Pradesh are said to benefit from the introduction of sustainable irrigation products and practice under a program offered by the International Development Enterprise India, that is IDEI, and supported with funding from the Walmart Foundation. A grant of $750,000. The Walmart Foundation will help IDEI take its integrating smallholder farmers into market systems program to 10 districts in the state of Andhra Pradesh. And the CEO of Walmart is Doug McMillan, and its headquarters is Arkansas, United States. And the CMO of Andhra Pradesh is N. Chandrababu Naidu. While we are discussing this common topic, we will be discussing the associated topics along with that. That's why I have discussed the CEO and the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. Now let us move on to the term of the day. Today I will be discussing avenue crop. What is this avenue crop? Friends, please mention if you know some example of avenue crop before I am explaining. Okay. Avenue crops are crops that are growing along the farm road and fences. Crops that are growing along farm road and fences. The examples are arhar, sisal and glycidia. I have mentioned one example in the image itself. The examples are arhar, sisal and glycidia. That is for today's news. In case you have any query, you can comment in the comment section. You can follow the Telegram channel mentioned in the description box. Don't forget to subscribe the channel if you are watching this for the first time, and share the information among your friends who are preparing for different competitive examination, mainly focused on agriculture. Thank you guys. Keep learning. Let us see in the next video. Stay tuned.